वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर इन टू अवर फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट मैकेनिक्स ऑफ सॉलिड। द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज ME201 एंड द टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टूडे इज द एलोंगेशन ऑफ अ टेपर्ड बॉडी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वॉट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टूडेज लेक्चर, लेट्स सी। First, to apply the concept of elongation of tapered body. Second, to study about the factors considered while taking elongation of tapered body. Third, to solve numericals based on the concept of elongation of tapered body. And fourth, to develop an in-depth learning about stress and strain. So these are the learning objectives. Basically, we are going to discuss about the elongation of tapered body. Now let's move into the discussion of this topic, elongation of a tapered body. As you can see, before in the earlier lecture, I have taught you about elongation of a body which is uniform in cross section, like this, whose cross section is same here, cross section here, and cross section here, it is same. All right, everywhere it is same. Then after, we have seen elongation of a body whose cross section is not same everywhere, it is like this. Elongation of a body whose cross section is not same everywhere, it is in this way, as you can see. Means there are different sections of different cross sections. But if we come now today, we are going to discuss about the case in which the whole body's cross section is uniformly changing, means that body is tapered on one side, it's a dimension is different, and on the other side its dimension is different, and the dimension is uniformly changing. I am talking about the cross section. So for this, there is a small derivation, since derivation part is not that much important as far as competitive exams is considered, so let's discuss about how its formula is derived. See, this is the tapered body. As you can see in the screen, this is the tapered body. All right. On one side, if its dimension or dia is b1, on the other side its dia is b2. You can take b1 or b2, or you can take d1 or d2. If you are taking d1, d2, you will write in the formula d1, d2. And if you are taking b1, b2, you will write in the formula b1, b2. If the load applied, this is the tapered body. All right, and the P is the load applied on it. And the body is uniformly tapering from one side to the other side. L is the total length of the original total length of the body of the rod, you can say. Now this is the middle portion which is being taken for derivation. Whenever we do derivation, we take a small part and then apply integration on that particular part and derive the formula. So we have taken for the time being a small portion b, whose this cross sectional length is b, whose small thickness is dx, and which is at a distance of x from the larger end. Now let t be the thickness. So what will happen, there is a long derivation regarding it, and through this derivation we come across a formula that change in length in case of a tapered body is equal to 4PL upon pi e d1 d2. We have done the integration. Finally after doing the integration, we have come across the final answer. All right, so the final formula for calculating the elongation of a tapered body is given by, as you can see in the slide, this it is given by change in length del is equal to 4PL upon pi e d1 d2, 4pl upon pi e d1 d2. So as you can see how it has been calculated, you can write in a different way also. How you can write, this is your load, this is the original length of the tapered body, this is the elastic constant, modulus of elasticity, and pi by 4 d1 d2, this has been used in place of area, and this is in maximum cases it is also known as area equivalent, equivalent area. So equivalent area, equivalent area means it is the term used to define this particular formula, pi by 4 d1 d2. Pi by 4 d1 d2 can also be used as, can also be written as area equivalent. So area equivalent, area equivalent is equal to pi by 4 d1 d2, and if you simplify, this 4 will go in the numerator and pi will be in the denominator. So the whole formula will become like this, 4pl upon pi e d1 d2, 4pl upon pi e d1 d2, upon pi e d1 d2. So this is the whole formula. Now on the basis of this formula we will solve some numericals and we will get a good control, good command on this particular topic. So let's move into the formula, let's move into the numerical. This is the first example. The example is saying to you, a circular alloy bar 2 meter long uniformly tapers from 30 mm diameter to 20 mm diameter. Alright, now what you have to do, you have to calculate the elongation of the rod under an axial force of 50 kilonewton, under an axial force of 50 kilonewton. So first of all, through diagram, by drawing the diagram, we will get the understanding. See, tapered means from one side it is of greater cross section and on the other side it is of a smaller cross section. All right. So now on this side the diameter they are giving to you is 30 on this side, 30 is on the bigger diameter 30, and diameter 20 is on the smaller side, and the distance between them is 2 meter. Now we have to calculate the elongation of the rod under the action of 50 kilonewton force. We have to find the elongation of this bar under the action of force equal to 50 kilonewton, under the action of 50 kilonewton force. Now as by the formula we all know, this force is denoted by P, diameter is denoted by small diameter, smaller diameter you can denote by D2, larger diameter you can denote by D1. All right, and the formula for calculating the elongation, del is equal to 4 P L upon pi E D1 D2, pi E D1 D2, 4 P L upon pi E D1 D2. So by putting all the values in place of load, you will have to convert it into kilonewton. It is in kilonewton, so you will have to multiply it by 10 to the power 3 to make it in newton. Again, you have been given the modulus of elasticity value as 140 gigapascal. This means it is equal to 140 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. So this is your g, this is your, sorry, this is the value of E which you will have to take. This is E, this is P, this is D2, this is D1, and this is the value of L. Taking all these values, you put in this formula, and you will get the answer. All right, let's see in the solution. So this is the solution. As you can see, as I have told you, similarly is given here. The length of the bar, it is in meter, so it has to be converted into mm. Then after, the diameter of the section, it is 30 mm, so no need to convert it into, it is already in a mm. Then diameter of section 2, that is D2, it is 20 mm. Axial force is in kilonewton, so you will get it converted into newton by multiplying by 10 to the power 3. And then modulus of elasticity E is given to you as 140 gigapascal. Gigapascal means it is equal to 140 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. Also, the final formula, del L is equal to 4PL upon pi E D1 D2. 4PL upon pi E D1 D2. If you put all the values, this P, this L, this D1, this D2, and this is your E value, then you will find the answer. Answer is 1.52 mm. You try to solve it by yourself and see whether you are getting this answer or not. Now moving into the next question. This is the next question. What the question is saying to you: a steel flat of thickness 10 mm tapers uniformly from 60 mm at one end to 40 mm at the other end in a length of 600 mm. See, thickness 10 mm to 60 mm at the other end, and total length is, thickness is given to you, and it is giving that it on one side it is 40 mm, on the other side it is 60 mm, and the total length is 600 mm. So let us draw the diagram. No, not of this, it will taper in this way. All right, it will not be of same dimension. It will taper in this way, it will taper in this way, it is in this way, all right. It is in this way. It is in this way. Now, on one side they have given you thickness, they have given to you. Thickness is not changing. Thickness is given to you as 10 mm. Thickness is same on both the sides, but it is tapering. Here it is 60 mm and here it is tapering to 40 mm. Rest, its total length is given to you. Its total length is 600 mm. Its total length is 600 mm. Its total length is 600 mm. Now you can take the Young's modulus or the modulus of elasticity value as given. And what is the percentage error? We have to find what is the percentage error if average area is used for calculating extension. So if average area is used for calculating extension, what will be the area? So this is the question in front of you. So first of all, we have to calculate the extension. Extension formula we all know. Extension formula says that del is equal to 4PL upon pi E D1 D2. 4PL upon pi E D1 D2. Now, as you can see, here the formula will not be D1 D2. Why? Because D1 D2 was used for circular cross section. D1 D2 was used for circular cross section. D1 D2 was used for our circular section tapered body. But here it is not the case of circular section tapered body. It is the case of a body whose cross sectional is rectangular, not circular. In case of rectangular sections taper body, the formula used is this: TL upon TE B1 B2 log B1 by B2. This is an important formula. What is the formula? TE B1 B2. This is the formula. PL upon TE B1 B2. PL upon TE B1 B2. This B1 B2 will be in bracket into log B1 by B2. Now here T is given to you. P is 80 kN, so you will convert it into Newton by multiplying by 1000. Then L is 600 mm. So write the value. No need to change it in any unit. And divided by TE. T is what? T is thickness. PL by TE. E is what? Modulus of elasticity. Now modulus of elasticity E is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. Since it is given in as 200 gigapascal, so we will write it as 2 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. Then after all the values B1, B2 are the dimensions of the both sides. B1 is larger one and B2 is smaller one. So B1 is 40 given to you and B1 is 60 given to you and B2 is 40. So 60 by 40 log 60 by 40, and it will be equal to 0.4865 mm. It is equal to 0.4865 mm. You just solve and try to find the answer, whether your answer is matching with this answer or not. If you are not matching the answer, if your answer is not matching with this answer, this means that there is might be some calculation mistake. Then again you solve this question. Now this is the elongation. This formula you should keep in mind. Sometimes this formula you use whenever the cross section is not circular. Cross section, if it is circular, then it will be 4PL upon pi d1 d2, and if it is not circular, it is of rectangular shape like this one. If the rod is of this type, then in that case what you will do, you will not use 4PL upon pi d1 d2 formula. In that case you will use the formula PL upon T capital E into bracket B1 minus B2 bracket close into log B1 by B2. So this is the formula for finding the extension of the tapered bar, and the answer is 0.4865. Now if we have to find average cross section, if for example we take the average cross section means if we find the average of the cross section of both the sides and use that area as a formula, what will be the answer? We all know that if we use average cross section, then we all know that by formula elongation is equal to PL upon AE. We all know that a change in length or elongation is equal to PL upon AE, where A is here in this case we are using average. So A we are using in this case as average. So here, now here also what we will do here in this question, students, for finding the average, what we will do, first of all we will have to find the average of the area on both the sides. So 60 into 10, this is the area on one side cross section, and on the other it is 40 into 10. 40 is the length which has been changed and 10 is same across whole. It is the thickness, not the width. Width is changing from 60 to 40, but the thickness is 10 everywhere. So 60 into 10 plus 40 into 10. This is the area. We have added the area and divided by 2 for getting the average, and the average is 500 mm square. Now this average area we will put in this formula PL upon AE. So by putting in this formula you will get 0.480 as the average elongation, as the elongation considered while taking the average. Now this is 0.480 and this is 0.4865. There is some difference in the answer, of this and this. There is some difference in the answer. So this difference in the answer, can be interpreted by giving the percentage error value. So the percentage error value will be this value, larger value, minus the smaller value, means 0.4865 minus 0.48 divided by 0.4865 into 100. So this is the percentage error. So from this you can calculate the error, percentage error. So two things were asked in this numerical. One was the percentage error and the second was the total extension. Three things, actually there are three things that has to be calculated in this numerical. First was the elongation of the tapered bar, rectangular, and since the bar had a rectangular cross section, so the formula was this, which has been used. This was the formula, PL upon TE V1 V2 log V1 by V2, PL upon TE V1 V2 log V1 by V2, PL upon TE V1 V2 log V1 by V2, PL upon TE V1 V2 log V1 by V2. This formula should be known to you. Then after, you have to calculate the average area. And by calculating the average area, you will put this area in this normal formula. We all know that for a normal cross section area bar, the formula is such elongation is equal to PL upon AE. So finally, percentage error you will calculate, the difference of the elongation obtained by this formula and this formula. We will subtract and divide by the original value, means 0.4865, means this one, the value obtained by this formula, and then we will multiply by 100 and we will get the percentage error, and the percentage error is 1.348%. So this was also a good question. All right, now moving to the next question, next numerical. What is the next numerical? This is the next numerical, and this is an important numerical. I have included this numerical because though it is looking very simple, but here something extra has to be done, which we have not done in previous lecture. Here the total load will not be taken same everywhere. Why? Because in the question itself, you can see in the diagram, the load here is 10 kN written and here it is 5 kN written. So due to these new entries, we can't take the load in all the three sections, means section AB, section BC and section CD as same. We can't take all the three sections load same. Here it is on the load A, on the load 1 it will be, on the load 1 it will be 20 kN, all right. On load 3 it will be 25 kN, but on load 2 how much it will be, that we will have to calculate. And how we will calculate? See, if this is the bar and on one side you are writing 25, all right, tensile, if that is tensile load, then it means that obviously this side also it is 25. We write in this way, no? So 25 this side, but on this side it is written 10 kN. This means that the part number 2, the section number 2 has got, the section number 2 has got some load in this direction, due to which the load in this direction has become 10. So what will be the load in this direction? So that it is 10 given to you, though it should have been 25. So we can say that there is some, 25 minus 10 you will get 15. So 15 kN load is there on the second part, due to which it is showing 10 kN. So if you are not able to understand the concept, then directly you can minus these two terms. Which one? 25 minus 10. And whatever is the value in that direction, you will make the remaining load direction. For example, here you can see it is 25. Here it is 10. Both are in opposite direction. You just minus it and make the direction in the larger direction. So in this direction, it will be 15. All right. So 15 is the load in the part number 2. So now this is the only concept which has to be used. See, on the first part there was no confusion, 25 kN will be the load. On the third part, sorry, on the first part which we have considered first, this was the first. On the first part the load was 20 kN, which we have considered. All right, and on the third part it is as we have calculated 15 kilonewton. So this is the whole sole value. So now we will move into the solution of this. Let's see. As you can see, length, nothing we can do it, we convert it into mm. Length of first part, 1 meter it is given, we can convert it into mm by multiplying it by 1000. Diameter of first part is given to you. Length of second part is given to you. Diameter of second part is given to you. We are writing for second part subscript 2. Length of third part means 3, L3 is given to you. Diameter of third part is given to you. And modulus of elasticity is given to you of the whole, because the material is same. Therefore, the modulus of elasticity value is same. Now, we know that area of the first and third part of the bar are, since the cross-sectional area, both first and the third part, both are having the same cross-section. So, cross-section area A1 and A3, both will be pi d square by 4. This is the formula used for circular cross-sectional area. So, if d is given to you as 15, then in that case, pi by 4 into 15 square, we will get 177 mm square. So, A1 and A3 are 177. And the middle portion, A2, for that, the diameter is 20 mm. So, you will put this value and you will get the area. Now, for the sake of simplification, the force of 25 kN acting at D may be split up into two forces of 15 and 10 kN. Similarly, the force of 20 kN acting at A may be split up into two forces of 15 and 5 kN. So, this is also a step which can be performed. Alright, now it will be seen that the bar ABCD is subjected to a tensile force of 15 kN. Part BC is subjected to a compressive force of 5 kN and part CD is subjected to a tensile force of 10 kN. We all know that the formula for elongation of a composite bar is this, PYE into L1 by A1 plus L2 by A2 plus L3 by A3. So, by putting this 15 kN as the load, we can calculate. Alright, so we will get, by putting 15 kN load, we will get this thing. Similarly, for bar AB means the first section, due to compression of 5 kN, you will get this value. And for part CD, due to tensile force of 10 kN, you will get elongation 0.3 mm. Now, add the elongations obtained by all the three sections and you will get total elongation. A total elongation which you will get is 1.85 mm. Alright, so as you can see, this question was also simple. You have to only judge whether which value you will take. If you are taking 15 kN value for a particular portion, for all the three portion, if you have taken 15 kN value, then two more values you will have to calculate, because on one side it is 25 and on the other side it is 20. So what you will do, you will have to do some extra calculation. So as you can see in the diagram also, here 15 kN load has been considered everywhere. Then after, what you are doing on the first part, 5 kN, you are taking more, because more 5 kN is considered on the first part. And on the third part, you are taking 10 kN more, because 10 kN more load is being visible here. So in this way also you can calculate and add the total elongation. It is an important numerical. You should be able to solve this numerical. Alright, there are multiple ways to solve this numerical. One I have already explained you. Second is the one whose diagram you are seeing here, that for the whole combined, you first of all take out the total extension as normally you calculate by taking the load as 15 kN. Alright, then after, for this part, means the first part, third part and the first part, here you don't have 15 kN load, you have 20 kN load, so you considered 20 minus 15, it is 5. So extra 5 kN load you apply on this first part and find the elongation. and on the third part the total load as you can see is 25 kilonewton. So extra 15 you have already used and filed the elongation by taking it in the whole of the bar. But here the load on the third part is 25, on the third section is 25, and 15 you have calculated. So the remaining 10 kilonewton load you will consider individually on the third part and try to calculate the elongation. And at finally you will add the elongation obtained by this step plus this step plus this step. All right, I hope you are understanding this numerical. This is an important numerical. You should get the understanding. Now coming into the next numerical, this is also a bit important, interesting numerical which you should be able to solve. Coming into this numerical, as you can see, this numerical is based on a tapered body, but at the same time there is different load at different part of this body. So again we will divide this whole of the part into different sections: section 1, section 2, section 3. First of all, what is the load acting here? It is 30 kilonewton, here it is 50 kilonewton. Alright, and in between also there is some load. So here it is 50 and it is here it is 70. So more or less, first of all we can take the value, we can divide the all the three sections. This is our, for example, section number 1. Alright, and in section number 1 the load which is acting is 30 here, so we will take 30. On the section number 3 the load is 50 kilonewton, so in section number 3 30 we will take 50 kilonewton. Alright, and in between section, in the middle section, what we will do, the remaining, if it is 50 here then it will be 50 also in this direction. So why it is written 70? This means that there is added load in this direction, and that will be of how much? 20. Therefore 20 plus 50 will become 70. So 20 load is in this direction, this will be applied in this part number 2, and if it is in 20 this side then it will be 20 this side. Means for the part number 2 the load which you will take will be 20 kilonewton. For the part number 2 the load which you will take is 20 kilonewton. For the part number 2 the load which you will take is 20 kilonewton. So these are all the three: first, second, third. All right, and the load for the first and the third part is very easy. Since the load is given on this direction, it is 30, means 30 is the load acting on the first. See the load at the extreme right, it is 50, means the 50 is the kilonewton is the load for the third part. For the middle part only you will have to calculate. And how you will calculate? Since on the third part the load applied on the extreme left is 50, means there will be some load here also in this direction. 50 equal to 50 means compressive load is applied in this way, no? In this way compressive load is applied. So 50 from this side also it will be, but it is given 70, means there is some load, there is some extra load, 20 kilonewton load. So that will be considered as tensile load on part number 2. And if it is in 20 kilonewton on this side, means we will have to write 20 on this side. Means the load T value P2 will be taken as 20 kilonewton. For the first part 30, for the third part it is 50, and for the middle part it will be 20. And now the calculation will be easy. All the other values are given to you. Total length is given 4 meter. All the values which are given in meter, you will have to convert it into mm. For that, multiply with 1000. Similarly, the load values are given in kilonewton. You can apply for converting it into newton, you will have to multiply again with 1000. And you have modulus of elasticity value also, and that is 120 gigapascal. 120 gigapascal means 120 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. 120, how much it is? 120 into 10 to the power 3 newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. Alright, so I hope you have understood this concept. Now let's see the solution of this numerical also. See, this is the solution as I have discussed with you. The same is written here. Length, convert, force, again convert to Newton, force P2 70, then modulus of elasticity, it is converted into Newton per mm square by multiplying with 10 to the power 3. Then from the geometry of the figure, we can see the diameter of the bar at B. Now here one more thing is important. You will have to calculate the individual diameters. And how you will calculate? For example, you have been given the diameter of this side as D1. Alright. And on this side it is D2. And if someone asks you what will be the diameter at this portion in middle, how you will calculate, then for that case what you will do, this length you will have to, this is x, then you will have to use the formula. What will be the formula? Formula will be in this way. What if a d1 plus d1 plus d1 plus what is the diameter? D1 minus d2, d1 plus d1 minus d2, means you can write in a different way. You can write the smaller one first, d2. If you are considering d2 as a smaller, you can write d2 plus d2, d2 plus d1 minus d2, all right, divided by, now you can divide the value, the distance. As you can see here also, you can see the same has been used. What is used? 1/4 means, 1/4 means it is the that particular ratio of that area. Means since the B portion, this B portion, it is at a distance of 1, and the total length is how much? 4. So in terms of ratio of the distance, if someone asks you what is the ratio of the distance, it is 1/4. All right, so 1/4 into the diameter of this side means 20. Alright, 20. Again, I am writing 20 plus what is the diameter on the extreme this side? It is 40. So 20 plus 40 minus 20. 20 plus 40 minus 20 into 1/4 into 1/4 into 1/4. You can write in this way. Alright, 40 minus 20 into 1/4 in this way. Alright, so once again I am repeating, because this is an important concept. What you have done, what you have to do, if for finding the diameter of this section, you will have to, the diameter at this section will be equal to this section diameter plus difference of the diameter of this extreme sections, means 20 plus 40 minus 20 into the that particular ratio. Means if this portion B section is at a distance of 1 meter and the total is 4, 1/4 into 1/4 you will have to do. Similarly for this C section, what you will do, now write it by yourself, just guess what will be the value for this C section. What will be the value? We will do the same thing, 20 plus what is the diameter in this extreme position, means D2, D1 means 40 minus extreme at this point is 20. The only thing that will be changed is the, now what I am writing to you. Here it is at a distance of what? It is at a distance of 1 plus 2 mm, total it will be 3 mm. So 3 into 3 by 4. Alright, so this is the whole soul. This is the whole soul answer of diameter at the section C. So I hope you have got the idea of how to calculate the diameter here and here. You can see the concept is now, I think, understandable by you. You have understand the formula. And similarly, the second thing, the second twist in this formula was what? This, the force which you have calculated on the individual sections. That was also a bit tricky, so that should be kept in your mind. Two things: one is diameter of the middle portions, and the second is the force which are acting on individual portions. And finally, if you have to calculate the shortening of the length of total shortening of the length of the bar AB, what is the formula? We all know for lambda is del is equal to 4PL upon pi E, and I extreme this corner D1 and this corner D2. In this way you can obtain, but that will be different for different particular section. For section 1 you write it at del 1, for section 2 you will have to write del 2, and for section 3 you will have to find write del 3. But if the nature of the loads are different, if they for tensile you will write plus, and if any load is compressive then you will write minus sign. How? See here, if you can see the in middle, the load was compressive load, so we have put up minus sign here. But the load at the first section and the third section, extreme sections, that load was tensile, so we have put the positive sign. But in the middle section the load was compressive, therefore we have put a minus sign on it. All right, as you can see here, it is I think visible to you. All right, or the reverse can be said about it, that the load was compressive on these two either corner sides part, and in the middle part it is tensile, so the nature of this can be taken as positive if these two will be added in elongation or shortening, and this will be subtracted. All right, so this was a good conceptual question. You please again try to solve this numerical. This was an important numerical. Now moving into the MCQs, multiple choice questions. The deformation per unit length of an object on application of load is called as, we all know the deformation per unit length of the object is known as what? It is known as strain. Strain is change per unit length. So change in length upon original length is your strain, and change in length is also known as deformation. So first is your answer. All right, moving into the second MCQ. Second MCQ is saying to you that the elongation of a bar of length L and weight W due to its self weight is given by, we all know that's due to self weight, the elongation, this I will discuss you again in the coming lectures also, the deformation due to self weight is WL upon 2AE. All right, so C is the correct answer. Now coming into the third numerical, third MCQ. Now in this MCQ you will have to solve this. What is written? A circular bar 2.5 meter long tapers uniformly from this particular value to this particular value. It is asking you to find the extension of the rod when the pull is of 30 kilonewton. So the question, I think you can understand, it is given that D1 is here, D2 is here. Diameters of both the sections are given to you and the length is given to you. All right, and by the formula you can get the answers. What is the formula? 4PL upon pi E D1 D2. So this answer, if you will calculate, and you will get that C is the correct answer. The correct answer is C, 1.6 mm. MCQ number 4, a copper rod circular in cross section uniform staperly from 40 mm to 20 mm in length of 11 mm. Now this question is also similar to the previous question. Again, the length has been given to you. Alright, diameter on the both the sides has been given to you, and the magnitude of the force have to be calculated, but the deformation has been given to you. So no need, only one unknown is there, and the formula we have 4PL upon pi D1 T2. EL value is also given to you. So you use the values and calculate the answer. This is also easy by calculation. You will get the answer. C is the correct answer. Now moving further, again a question, a steel bar 3 meter long uniformly tapers from 50 mm diameter to 25 mm diameter. Find the magnitude of force which will deform it by 0.8 mm. It is very much similar to the previous numerical. Again, a tapered bar, both the sides diameter have been given to you, its length has been given to you, deformation has been given to you. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate the magnitude of force applied. You have to calculate the force applied. When you will calculate the value, it will be your option C. So in this way, moving into the next MCQ. What is the next MCQ? Next MCQ is here, a rectangular bar 2 meter long and 12.5 meter thick uniformly tapers from 100 mm at one end to 20 mm at the other end. Now here, One should, what is the question is saying further, if the bar is subjected to a tensile force of 25 kilonewton, find the deformation. Now here see, deformation formula is different from the previous one. The deformation formula for rectangular cross section is different. This I have already told to you. So try to use the formula which is for rectangular cross section. So when you will calculate, you will get the answer of this one. You will get the answer. I hope this answer for this is DD is the correct answer for this. Calculate and try to check it. Now MCQ number 7. A steel bar of 100 mm length taper from 12 mm by 10 to 30 by 20 at the other end. If the steel in the bar is not to exceed 100 MPa, find the magnitude of axial forces. It is asking you the magnitude of the axial forces. Similarly, as the previous one, we have to solve this one. When you will solve, you will get D as the correct answer. Now, coming into the question number 8, a steel bar is there, ABCD, at which different loads are given to you. And it is asking you what will be the value of elongation. So again, this type of question also I have also solved in example. So by seeing the same way, you can solve this also. The answer is A. Then the ninth one, a circular bar 2.5 meter long tapers uniformly from this diameter to this diameter, determine extension of load under a pull of 30 kilonewton. Again the same thing, you have the dimension of both the sides and you have to calculate the extension. So here also when you will calculate, you will get the answer. Answer is your C answer. Alright, now coming into the 10th MCQ, a copper rod circular in section taperly uniforms from 20 mm to 40 mm and the length is 11 mm. It is asking you the magnitude of the force, similar to the question which I have already discussed with you. The deformation is given to you, E has been given to you. When you will calculate, you will get the answer. Alright, so I hope you have understood this today's class very nicely. See the answer of this numerical. I hope you have understood all the concept of deformation of a bar which is tapering in section, means deformation of a tapered bar. I hope you have understood this. Now in the coming lecture, we will discuss something new related to this topic. Thank you. These are the references. Let's see the references which I have used. These are the references. The books which I have referred. You can see Timoshenko, Shames, Popo. These are the important books. And one textbook is also there. That is R.K. Bansal book. So you can refer these all books. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.